guys, it's your girl AP, and welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm going to be giving you a quick tutorial on how you can make candles like so. These are just a couple that I've done in the past. Simple little home decor you can do for yourself or for the upcoming holiday. Okay, and it's been a while since I did a video, so I'm excited. But we're going to learn how to make these simple, cute home decor candles, guys. You're going to love this video. So for the video, you're going to need some pilar candles. Pillar candles, pilar candles, whatever you want to call them. I got these from a local discount store, but you can pretty much find them like any arts and crafts store, discount store, all-purpose store. You can find candles, you know? So I'm going to just take the wrapper off mine. So I got, for the video today, I'm going to be using a large one, and I'm going to be using a smaller one. Okay, so let's just get in it. And the prices for these candles were pretty expensive. I could have got them cheaper, which I did get them cheaper. At Target had two in the pack, the large ones, for about $5.99. These were at a discount store. I paid $5 for the large one, $2.50 for the small one. But whatever, let me just position the camera a little quickly. So you're gonna need some candles. You're gonna need a hair dryer or a heat gun. Today I'm gonna be using my heat gun. I ordered this from Amazon for about $12. But if you have a handheld hair dryer, that'll work perfectly fine too. You're also gonna need some scissors, some wax paper. This is very key. You're gonna need some wax paper. I got this from a discount store for $1.50. You can get it from Dollar Tree for flat for $1 too. You're gonna need your computer to print your image, which I'll show you shortly. You're gonna need some copy paper, just a regular sheet of copy paper. And you're going to need some tissue paper, like, you know, the kind of tissue paper you wrap, you know, when you stuff in your gift bags, that kind of tissue paper, and you're gonna need that in white, okay? All right, so let's just get right into making this candle. Okay, so I wanted to just show you, let me see if I can zoom in. Oh no, I can't. Well, I'll just move closer. I just wanted to show you what you'll need your laptop for, and that's just setting up for the design, what you want to put on your candle. Once I print the candle, you'll get a better view of it, but I'm using Canva to design. I love Canva. Canva's a free free app for your phone, for your desktop, for your laptop, but I have Canva Pro. I pay for Canva Pro, which is worth it, okay? I just went ahead and paid the full year, and I love it, okay? This is where I do all my designing in. All right, so I'm gonna go ahead and show you how I set my image up for printing, okay? So this is the image that we're printing. We're printing two images. The larger one is gonna be for our larger candle, and the smaller the words are gonna be for our smaller candle, okay? So let me show you the key point for setting up for printing for these candles. All right, for setting up for printing for these candles, you wanna make sure you put your tissue paper at the bottom and just lay your copy paper somewhere in the center of the tissue paper, okay? So I'm gonna just lay it more so at the top. And then once you get it there, you wanna cut off all the excess, just leave enough to fold over onto the copy paper. So just enough to fold over and tape. So you wanna cut off all the excess copy paper, tissue paper. You're not gonna use it, so just go ahead and ball it up and pull it to the side. And then go ahead and cut off the sides, same way, just leaving enough to fold over and tape. Okay, and then you're gonna see why we do the fold over and tape in a moment. Okay, and then we're just gonna go ahead and cut this side, and then I'm gonna show you our next steps for setting up. Sorry, I just had a piece of tape for these candles. And this is the key step. If you don't do this step, I don't think you can achieve the look of, you know, this kind of look. This is the key step. So once we have that, go ahead and fold the tissue paper to the edge of the copy paper. It doesn't matter if it's crooked. Just make sure you get it to the edge. And go ahead and do that all the way around. Just do it all the way around. Okay? Okay, now I'm just getting it ready because what we're going to do, we're going to tape all of this down to secure it onto the copy paper. So the copy paper is basically just giving us our base, that sturdiness that we need to print on. So the printer could detect this some kind of paper, because you just can't put the regular tissue paper inside the printer. It will jam or something will happen, okay? So I don't have any regular tape, and I'm being a bad, bad girl right now because I'm using some expensive sublimation tape that I know I should not be using, but I don't have any regular tape right now, so I have to use this. But this is normally the tape, my heat tape, that's not cheap, not no regular $2, $3 tape. This is the only tape I have right now, so this is why I'm using it, and it's gonna work perfectly fine because this is the tape that I've used for the other candles. But you guys, y'all have regular tape, that's fine. That's what's preferred to use, okay? Any regular sticky tape. I never use masking tape. I've only seen people that done this use white tape. Clear tape, but I'm sure any kind of tape will work. You know what I mean? We'll get the job done. So just go with what you have in the house just to hold it down. And all you're going to see me doing is just taping down the sides like so, cutting strips of tape, and laying it down, making sure it's secure onto the sheet of paper. That's all I'm doing. And then once I finish this, you want to insert this sheet inside your printer, whatever way your printer prints. So I know some people printer prints, you got to face it face down. Some people, you just slip it in at the top. Mine's is like a slipping at the top type of thing. So all I have to do is slip this sheet of paper into the slot and press print, and it'll begin printing. I'm just going to put a little piece at the top. I noticed that a piece at the corner was lifting. Yeah, I see it right here. And the reason why you want to make sure it's taped down, because you don't want it to get jammed or, you know, mess up your print. And you want it to be pretty. This image that I'm going to show y'all once it print is so pretty. And I got it from Etsy, where I get a lot of my images from. Okay, so, all right. So this is the end result. This is what you want to have, okay? Taped down, secured. And I'm going to go ahead and slide this into my printer like so, however your printer prints. And I'll come back and show you how the image looks. Be right back. Stay tuned. All right, guys, we're back. Image is all printed. This is what you should have. Remember I told you how pretty the image was? This is why I wanted it to be. Look. And I'm just using, if anyone want to know what kind of print I'm using, I'm just using a regular HP Office Jet inkjet printer. That's it. Okay, and it looks so vibrant on the tissue paper, okay? And I'm going to show you the next step, so just stay tuned. So I'm going to go ahead and cut this out, cut out our images. And as far as cutting it out, you just want to make sure you're getting to as close to the image as possible. You don't want to leave too much white around your image, okay? So I'm just cutting my images out, getting as close as possible, and then this is what we're going to use. We're not even going to use the paper. We don't need that. We need the actual image that's printed onto the tissue paper. So I'm just going to go ahead and trim around all this excess white, whatever I can get off, closer, as close as possible. Okay, that's all I'm doing. Being careful not to cut any of my image off, because this is so pretty. And what you could do, you can lay it against the candle like I always do, just to get a glimpse on how it's going to look. It's going to look beautiful, okay? It's going to look pretty. And then go ahead and do the same thing for your other image that's going to go on the smaller candle. And the image just says God designed. I don't know if you guys could see it, but it says God designed. And this, I'm just going to go ahead and clean this up, clean up the image, cutting off all the excess white, whatever we don't need, off of the image. That's all I'm doing. And next, you want to go ahead and prep your wax paper. So this is where your wax paper is going to come in. Just go ahead and cut a big enough piece to maybe split it into two little wraps. okay? And I'm gonna show you why. All right, so go ahead. Oh, I forgot. You're also gonna need some glue. Let me grab my glue, be right back. All right, guys, I'm sorry. I had to get the glue. So this is the glue that I'm using, and this is the glue that I found that works best. I find it at my local discount store, but I'm not sure where you can find it. I've never seen it at Michael's or Hobby Lobby. But what you're gonna do, you're gonna take this glue, and you're just gonna put just enough around the edges. Not a lot, just enough to stick it to the candle. Okay, so I like to lay it flat when I'm putting on the image. I usually do this in my lap, but for video purposes, I'm just gonna do it like so. You can take your finger and kind of push the image down to the candle. And then once you have it onto the candle and the image is smushed down, you wanna go ahead and wrap it with the wax paper, which is gonna serve like a barrier. And remember your heat gun I spoke about in the beginning of the video. You're gonna need the heat gun right now. And here's where you have to be very careful, because yes, some of the candle will melt away, but you can have a napkin close to wipe it down. Go ahead and turn your heat gun on to the strongest setting and get close to the image as possible. And you wanna do it in maybe for about 30 seconds to 45 seconds, making sure you are completely taking the heat gun around the entire image. If you have some heat gloves, that'll be good too. I should have put on a pair of heat gloves, but my heat gun doesn't get as hot. I'm just making sure I get the bottom. And here we go. I'm just gonna check it now. And how you can check it is just do a pill and our image is ready. Okay, look how easy that was, okay? And you just wanna let it dry for about maybe 5 to 10 minutes, and this candle's done and ready, all right? And we're gonna do the same thing for our small candle, okay? Same method. Take the glue, drag it around the, you know, just around the edges. And after you do that, lay your candle flat or however you wanna lay the candle. Okay, just make sure you have your image right where you want it, okay? I think I'm gonna pull it down some, if I could, yeah. All right, now take your wax paper, wrap it again for about 30 to 45 seconds. You wanna go ahead and place your heat gun onto, look, my nail done popped off during this video, y'all, it's crazy. Go ahead and take your heat gun and just get it nice and hot onto the edges, making sure you kind of know it's ready when it starts to look shiny. It goes from that matte look to that shiny look. That's when you know it's ready. That's my research. When it goes from that matte to that shiny look, you know it's ready, okay? Once again, I'm just gonna test it, and voila, we are all ready, okay? And this is our quick tutorial on how you can make quick little candles for the upcoming holiday. Let me move these out the way. Okay, quick little candles for the upcoming holiday, okay? I hope you guys love this video, this quick, easy DIY. Don't forget to subscribe and like this video and share with your friends. Bye.